water chords. In two videos, I will explain how to get a different sound. Different from playing thirds, which is good, but not as open as the quarter voicings, with perfect fourth. It's a different hand position. You can, let's say, close the curtains and make the chords more narrow. But you can also open the curtains. Spreading the fingers. And the quarter chords, the chord with perfect fourth, gives a good example how open it can be and how open it can sound. Perfect fourth, we can practice them. We have to play all the possibilities, and it's not so difficult. You have to get used to it. I can't talk it in. You have to practice it. You have to realize that on C and C sharp, it's mixed black and white keys, like F and F sharp, and all the other ones are white or black. Makes life a little easier. A good way to practice it is with two hands, one on C, one on D, and go chromatically. And when you can say your telephone number, 06, no, I won't. When you can say your telephone number, you know you can do it. See? So, practice it. Minor third. Whatever. To get used to it. Left hand, right hand. Do it separate. Separate and just give it a try. Because when we will use it, it will get much easier. Perfect fourth. We can see in the scale of C where the perfect fourth would fit. And it's not on C, because we would have a B flat. It's on D, E, not on F, G, A, and B. So, on those five, it will fit. It's a pentatonic scale of G. In some way, fourth chord and pentatonics are related. We will hear that in the second video when we go more in the McCoy-Tyner style. But when we would play quarters on B flat, we played all the five black keys. It's this. See? So there's a relation between fourth chord and a pentatonic. When this is possible in the scale of C, those five possibilities we have when we play the chords of C, in the scale of C. C chord, an F chord, a G7 chord, a D minor chord, an A minor chord, E Phrygian. All those chords we can fill is those five quarter chords. So, then we just have to try where it fits. C. On D, it's possible, but a little dull, because the G and the C is already in the bass. See? This is the extra one. So it's not so special. On the second one, I play it a little lower because it's more a chord thing. And that's a beautiful sound. So on the three of C, that's a good sound. That would be a nice intro or an ending, you know? On the three, half step up, so not the three of D flat, B. Sounds good. On five, it's a little dull because we have the five and the one, and a sus4, which doesn't fit on. That that doesn't work. On the 6, that's also a good sound. It's a kind of extension of the one on the 3. See? Major 7. That's a nice one. Major 7, we hear it's a major 7 chord. The 3 and the 6, which makes it very major 7. So on major 7, I would say, on the 3, 6 and major 7. Maybe the 6 and major 7 makes it even more major 7. So on F in C, which is also a major chord, would be on the 3, the 6 and major 7. And it works like that. Although F in C is Lydian, and this nasty sharp in 11 would be nice to let it bloom. Oh, that's nice. So, and it fits in the 5 possibilities. So I would say major 7 is nice on C on the 6 and major 7, A and B. And in the Lydian, maybe the same too. It's nice when you use the chord tones to make melody. The melody opens up. It's just a different world with those quarter voicings. So we tackled the major chords. Then minor. We had a D, E, G, A. That's a nice special sound. Maybe not so strange that in So What, we use those two. It's a little abstract. It's not really D minor as in D minor, but usable. On 1 and 2, it's good. On 4, okay. A little empty maybe on the 5. That's also a nice one. Just try. I would say to start with minor chords on 1 and 2. It's a little open because there's no third in it, so you don't hear if it's minor or major or minor. So A minor fits good. E minor, we don't have a G, F sharp, but it's a Phrygian E. It's a little strange sound, so maybe we need a special fourth chord. See, is that a nasty one? And I think I prefer that one for the Phrygian chord. So we tackled a little bit the major and minor settings. Download the PDF and I will explain the possibilities there again. To be very practical, just practice your major chords on 3 and 6. When I play it on 6, when you have big hands, you can play it at once. With a little, when your hands are a little smaller, I would play the quarter chords together with the thumb. So this top sound is just one sound. It sounds better than this. Something like that. I think this is a good sound for major. Just one step, the dominant 7 chord. Because a fourth chord has also something sus4. Like on G. See? So a quarter voicings has something when you count from the bottom part. It has a dominant 7th sus4 sound. And you can't go from this 4 to the 3 after the resolution. And when you get used to it, it's easy also when you play a melody on top. Some people say you can't play a third when it's sus4. I don't know, I like the sound. Gives an extra tension, but just think what you think. So sus4 is good. I can add a second chord on top, which is good to practice. Your fourth chord, you know, you can even practice and say your telephone number. 06, no, I won't. But when you can and talk, you know you've done a good job. So, on C and on D, see the sus4, how good it works. I need four hands to do this. With a bass and melody on top, it would sound really nice. Very easy and a good sound. So that's nice. So, that's one. On one and on two. Because a chord is not a static thing. In fact, a chord is a bunch of melodies. So we can shift part of the chord as being a melody, like the two notes in the right hand going a half step down. See, it gets... It's a kind of flat 9, sharp and 11. Get used to the sound, but it's easy to shift. I did it downwards. I can go up. Yeah. So that's another possibility. Four on the root. Fourth chord on the two. Just experiment with it. When you get used to open your hands a little bit, the sound will get different, and that's a nice thing. I use these quarter chords in a third surrounding, so in normal standards. Yeah? That's this video. In the second video, we talk more in an abstract modal sound. One last thing, you can practice this. It's good for an end sound. I put the thumb on the three, move it as soon as possible. You see a lot of possibilities with this fourth chord, and it gives a different open sound.